In this video, I will walk through how to configure automatic actions for a SAS Visual Analytics report and talk about example use cases for when to use each type. There are three types of automatic actions: one-way filters, two-way filters, and linked selection. One of the behaviors of automatic actions is that it is applied at the page level of the SAS Visual Analytics report. If you are using the same data source for all of your objects on the page, then the filters and links will happen automatically. If you are using different data sources for your objects on the page and would like columns to be linked together, then you will need to map data for the report. Also, use color purposefully. You can use color to designate the different data sources, or you can use display rules to ensure that category data values retain a consistent color. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 2022.1 for the hands-on portion of the video, but the same techniques can be used in earlier releases, starting with Visual Analytics 7.5 and later. For my first example, I will be showing you one-way filters, but I will be using two data sources. We can see that I have Megacorp and Inside Toy, and each data source has a product line column that I want to use to be able to link together. We can see that I have four overlapping values, but in order to get these to map, I will need to create a custom category, you can see here named Product Line Custom, to use for the map data definition. My custom category will align these values so they match exactly, so the automatic actions will have something to link to. From the data pane, using either Megacorp or Inside Toys, I will use the data menu and select map data. And then for my Megacorp and Inside Toy data mapping, I will select to choose enable data mapping. And here I have two columns that I will configure for mapping. I have year. So for Megacorp, it's called date by year. For Inside Toy, the column is called transaction year. For Megacorp, I'm going to use that new custom category I created with the matching data values called product line custom. And then in Inside Toy, I created a similar custom category also named product line custom. And we'll click OK. Now let's go ahead and move to our one-way filter page. The first thing I want to show you is where to configure automatic actions. Since it is an action, we will be using our actions pane. And then from the dropdown, we will select the page name. So here we have the report name, YouTube automatic actions. Here we're going to look at the page level, one-way filters. We can see I already have automatic actions selected to be enabled for this page. And then I'm going to leave the one-way filter selected. You can see I've also selected to display my filter breadcrumbs at the top of the page, which will show up right here. So let's look at our first click path. Here we can see that I have Megacorp and Inside Toy objects that I've properly named to make it easier for the user. Up at the top here for my button bar, on my role assignment, we can see that I use the product line custom. We can see I'm using the larger one since it has a distinct value of 8. I'm pulling this from the Inside Toys. And we can see also the other control object I have on the report is my list selection. And it is also pulling from Inside Toy. And I know that because I have more years available in this data set than I do for Megacorp. So my automatic actions for one-way filters is already turned on, and I'm going to take a look at 2011 and 2010 data. We can see it automatically filters all of the objects on the page. Next, remembering that I have an overlapping category for product line figure, I'm going to go ahead and select figure, and it goes ahead and filters all of the objects on the page. And we can see up here my filter breadcrumb starting to play out as I select data values in the report, the 2010, 2011, and now figure. Remember, this is using our custom category, the product line custom, but we can see here I'm using the original column product line, and we can see for Megacorp, the actual value is called action figure, where for Inside Toy, the actual value is just figure. To start over, we can use the breadcrumbs to delete our selections. Now let's say we want to look at the year 2009. And let's go ahead and select another common product line across both of the data sources. We'll go ahead and select promotional. We can see our filter breadcrumb being built up at the top. And here we see, let's go ahead and select the coffee cup value. And here we can see on this particular selection, it only filtered the inside toy bar chart. And this is because we have not yet had a mapping between product made and product between the two different data sources. So if we wanted to add that, we would simply go back into our data pane. Before I showed you from the Megacorp, but we can select it from Inside Toys. It's fine. It's for it's a global setting for the report. So when we select map data, here's our Inside Toy and Megacorp data sources. We want to add another column mapping, and this is between the product make and product. And we'll go ahead and click OK. Go ahead and remove that last selection. So now when I select coffee cup, we can see that now that we have a mapping between product make and product, the filter is applied for all of the other objects on the page. Now we get an understanding of the way one-way filters work. Once a value is selected, then that value is applied as a filter for all of the other objects on the page. We saw if it was the same data source, we don't need any additional configuration done. Everything is filtered automatically. However, if it's a different data source, then we can easily map the columns using the map data menu. Okay, let's go ahead and move on to our two-way filter example. Two-way filters can help dive into multi-dimensional data. This is why I'm switching over to a different data source when you're looking at this data. I will be using the cars data source because I believe the hierarchy of origin, make, model is a fairly wide-known concept. So let's go ahead and verify that we have our two-way filter automatic action configured for this page. So again, it's an automatic action. We're going to use our actions pane. We have the, not the report level, but the page level selected, not the individual objects. So at the page level, make sure it's enabled. And in this case, we're going to be using our two-way filter. One of the prominent objects on this report is our stacked bar chart. Using objects that can display more than one dimension at a time is ideal when using two-way filters. Also notice that when I click on my bar chart and I select my rules, we can see that I have a display rule assigned for any category. So anytime for this bar chart, Asia will always be this teal color, Europe will be the green color, and the USA a lighter yellow color. And this is so that when any of the origins are subsetted, the first color in the data palette that is selected won't be always assigned depending on a subset of the origins. That Asia will always be this color, Europe will always be the green, and the USA will always be the yellow. So the key with two-way filters is when you select a value, the other objects are filtered. And then when you select additional values, again, all the objects are filtered, including the original one. So let's take a look at a click path so that we can see how this works. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select the origin Europe, and we can see how that selection that we can see in the filter breadcrumb here, that Europe rear, Europe front, and Europe all have been applied to the other two objects on the report page. The next thing I'm going to select is the type wagon for Europe. We can see how the numbers in our bar chart dropped down. Let's go ahead and just quickly undo that so we can see. We can see that our scale of frequency went up to 50. We notice our segment labels here. And then when we click on the Europe wagon, we can see those that drops down. The scale is now max frequency of 5. And finally, my third selection, if I were to select this Mercedes-Benz, we can see that again, another filter is applied in our filter breadcrumb, and the other two objects are filtered by this value. Go ahead and let's work with another type of click path. In this next example, let's take a look at all of the rear wheel drivetrain vehicles. The next selection I'm going to make is for all of the sports type. So the sport vehicles for Asia, Europe, and USA. We can see how the numbers for our segments are updated. We can also see down below how all of the list table rows that are returned are for the sports vehicles. And then if we were interested in the best highway miles per gallon, we can easily take a look at where those come from. But let's say we were interested in the top five. Again, I would just hold the control key and select the top five. And looking at the top five, we can see the distribution of what where the origin of these cars were made. So now we can see how the two-way filters will filter back on the original object as the filter breadcrumb is filled out as you are selecting values. In this particular example, I am only showing one data source in the cars data source since it was the most straightforward to explain. But again, if you wanted to use multiple data sources, you would just need to use the map data between the columns you would wish to link together. Okay, now moving on to our final automatic action, and that is linked selection. First thing we're going to do is check our actions pane, make sure that we have the page selected link selection. We have our automatic actions enabled, and we're going to choose our linked selection. And the key to using link selection is selecting related data and data items, but not using the exact same role assignment for all of the objects on your page. So let SAS Visual Analytics do all the work to simultaneously highlight the selected data points. And it's important for the report viewers to understand the roles that you chose to have in your objects and understand it is most likely going to be a part to whole relationship, since you're not going to always highlight the same level of detail in the data. So it's important to for your users to understand that the value that you've selected may not represent the entire value that is linked or highlighted. This is another good example of using color purposefully. We can see in this particular case that the blue is representing unit yield rate in our bar chart, as well as in our geo map with bubble overlay. So again, we've already looked at how using display rules in the stacked bar chart was important because then all of those data values remained the same. And here we're using color purposefully to represent one, in this case, unit yield or one type of measure. All right, so let's go ahead and dive into a few click paths. We can see here, I'm just filtering the data. So this is a page filter. I just have 2009 selected, that's fine. The first click I'm going to do is I'm going to select Louisiana. So once I select Louisiana, we can see that rows are highlighted in all of the other objects. So here with Louisiana selected, I can see that which product lines are being produced or manufactured in these facilities. We can see we have the action figure and the stuffed animal contributing to the Louisiana facility. We can see that it has the lowest unit yield rate according to this bar chart. And then here, right now I am sorted by unit, but again, if I just change the sort by facility, it'll go ahead and put all of those Louisiana facilities and units together for more detail that I have in my list table. So that's a link selection number one using the GeoMap. The next one, if we wanted to, for example, click on, just deselect that. If we wanted to select a row in our crosstab, let's for example say we want to look at the subtotal for action figure. Here we can see in our geo bubble that we have several facilities highlighted that produces products in the action figure. Now this is again one of those cases where we need to understand that this is not the only things being manufactured at these sites, but these are where the sites are. So again, making sure your users understand the relationship of the data is quite important. We can see those facilities highlighted in our bar chart. Also here, We have those facilities, but now we're looking at a particular unit. So I would change the sort if I were wanting to dive deeper into more information about the action figure product line and look at it this way. You could also make this larger using the maximize view in order to get a better look at all of those rows in one go. And then again, just restore view to bring it down to its other size. So that is the second link selection click path that I looked at. If we wanted to change and, for example, look at the bottom two performing facilities, we can see that, again, it links and highlights those on all of the other objects. Here we have Arkansas and Louisiana highlighted. We can see which product lines are being manufactured in those two facilities. Again, if we go through, since we're mainly looking at facilities, we might want to change the sort order. Here we have all of those Arkansas facilities grouped together and then the Louisiana. And finally, our last click path, if we wanted to look at unit variance, we can see that the highest unit reliability has the unit variance closer to zero. So if we wanted to look at the worst performing ones, we could again just hold our control as we multi-select these rows in the list table. And we can see that in the geo bubble, here we have Alabama highlighted as where the worst performing variance for unit yield is being done, what that corresponds to as far as product line, but obviously we know that's not the entirety produced out of this facility, and then where the facility falls as in the ranking as far as unit yield rate. So now you have seen examples for all three of the different types of automatic actions. We have our one-way filters, our two-way filters, our linked selection. Be sure to use data mapping when you need to link across multiple data sources, as well as color. Use it purposefully, either for meaning, representing either, you know, categorical data values or your measured data items. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or one of the blogs that walks through each of the automatic actions in more detail. I have additional screenshots and examples for each of the types of automatic actions, whether it's one-way filters, two-way filters, or linked selection, or check out one of the YouTubes for additional tips and tricks.